పాజిటివ్ ఎథిజం ఇంగ్లీష్ ఛానల్. టుడే ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రజెంట్ యూ ద బుక్ ఆన్ థాట్స్ ఆఫ్ పెరియార్ కంపైల్డ్ బై డాక్టర్ కె వీరమణి. సెకండ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ హిందూయిజం అండ్ సోషల్ రిఫార్మ్స్. దేర్ ఫోర్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ అస్ ఈస్ ద ఏజ్ ఫర్ ద వెడ్డింగ్. వెన్ ద కమిటీ ఫిక్సెస్ ద మినిమమ్ ఏజ్ యాజ్ 14, ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ సమ్ పీపుల్ థింక్ దట్ ది ఏజ్ షుడ్ బి రైజ్డ్, I would say that the age fixed by the committee is all right. It is a good thing that the committee has fixed the minimum age for the wedding without any reference to the attainment of puberty. If the committee had made any reference to the probable age for puberty in fixing the wedding age, fanatics would have said that it was against religion, that it was sinful, and the offenders would go to hell. If the wedding is to take place after a girl attains puberty, nobody would be in a hurry to get girls married, and the girls would be able to have good education and also get to know the world. They would not be compelled to marry the young man selected by the parents. Each girl would also develop the competence to select a suitable partner. Later, in course of time, there will be scope for love marriages. So I think that those who are interested in the welfare of women would welcome the statement of the committee that girls should be married only after they are 14 years old. Further, if religious compulsion is eliminated from this question, the ground will be cleared for the elimination of religious compulsions regarding matter that offend human nature and human intelligence. Therefore, we feel impelled to accept the recommendation of the special committee regarding the minimum age for a girl's wedding. When there was a proposal to stop the practice of burning a woman alone with the dead body of her husband, there were protests that the proposal was contrary to religious discipline. But when the law against this practice was boldly promulgated, that enabled widows to get married again. So too, if law is enacted fixing the minimum age for a girl's marriage, that will pave the way for raising the minimum age to 18. Further, women may get the right to avoid marriage and live as spinsters, hermits, and head of monasteries. Therefore, the important duty of social reformers is to avoid criticizing the proposal of the committee and get them passed in the legislature. Even before the government has formally published these proposals, the Brahmins have started propaganda against them in the name of religion and Varnashrama Dharma. Within 20 or 25 days after the news about these proposals came out in Tamil Nadu and in Andhra Pradesh, interested parties have arranged for meeting in one or two places daily, appealing to the government not to accept the proposals of the committee. They have been sending reports to the press that such resolutions have been passed at every meeting. Since it is usual for the Brahmins of our country to raise cries of protest against every reform without getting alarmed, we must hold our meetings in as many places as possible, pass resolutions supporting the committee's report, and send the resolutions to the government and the members of the legislature. This is very essential. Even before the enactment of the laws about the management of temples, these Brahmins raised cries in the same way, but the laws were passed. Still, we cannot say that the laws have benefited anybody so far. Committees were formed and officials were appointed, but no useful purpose was served. It has not been possible to stop wasteful expenditure, to affect the least economy, and spend the money for good purpose. Further, those who were consuming the temple funds continue to do so, and the situation regarding those who were insulted in the name of sanctity of the temples and those who were declared depressed classes continues to be the same. We have to say that the government, which comes to power through elections and functions through legislative bodies, is not at all suited to our situation. What we need at present is an administration like that of hero of Turkey, Kemal Pasha. We have to say this because the voters and representatives of the government are those who are in high post or advanced positions economically and otherwise. With the support of such people, the electioneering tricks and cunning schemes in the name of representation, the administration is carried on. Thank you.
Please download Samaram Multichannel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store and subscribe to the channels.
For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.